I think that sometimes leadership becomes a prisoner of history. And I think the real challenge of leadership is the capacity to have a vision and to imagine a new kind of history.
Human beings can make a difference. This theory, for example, the Ralph Nader theory, that it didn't make any difference, is to me obscene. It made a huge difference what happened in the year 2000. Mm-hmm. And people are the measure, and people can make a difference.
But the conversations I had were pretty much like the conversations I had waiting in, you know, I often talk about this. Those of you who are parents and do carpool lines know that it's really advantageous to get there early so that you're not waiting in the line forever. So you get there early, and so you spend a few minutes talking to the other parents who are there, almost exclusively mothers, but other parents who are there. Pickup time for school is the same time as Talk of the Nation. And so you would be hearing something on Talk of the Nation, and you would be, you know, it would really move you.
I'm sorry, it's Tell Me More in Washington, D.C.
during carpool time? Mm-hmm. Okay, well.
I'm big with carpool.
And,
but anyway.
The first time I met Ray Suarez, I said, you know, if something happens to my husband, I've always said I'm marrying you, because, you know, because he was so interesting listening to these things. But you'd get out of your car and you'd have these conversations. This was a continuation of the carpool line conversation that I had been having for years and years and years, just about a wider variety of things.
No, she's overwhelmed by some sense that she counts. She's noticed, she's seen, she's heard, she's felt. And the only way she responds to that is the way the Pentecostals do. I know lots of happy Christians. Now, when I go into mainline churches, some of which I could name right here, I look out at these rather grim people. They don't look very happy. They don't look very happy. I want to say, the Presbyterians need a good colonic. That's what they something needs to loosen them up and give them a little sense of.
As someone who was raised Presbyterian, I got to say amen.
Don't you know what I'm talking about?
Older my breed, this old to quality. See live what you told me, I ride with you, homie, now.
In space it flowed. From here I see the coast. Would you be there, my love, if I need you most, most?
Well, it is interesting that most of us, I think, when we think about civility, the first image that comes to mind is two people yelling at each other on a cable television show, or someone running a negative ad or something like that. But I actually think that we shouldn't think of civility first as something about expression or speech. I think we should think of it first as a sacrifice. Civility to me is the set of sacrifices that we make for the sake of living a common life. It's the self-restraint of not cutting that driver off in traffic, or not cursing at that person on the television screen who has a different point of view. The ability to pull back from that instinct, that impulse to do as we like, when we like, without regard to consequences. That sacrifice, I think, is civility.
Am I blinking? Yeah. Such a woeful schism. The pain in our existence was not as I envisioned. Boots that tramp from track to track, worn down to the soul. When road was paved in gold, when road was just a road.
I've been given a lot of shirts. But when I first started out, I was just buying them out of the Shepherd's catalog. Now the Shepherd's catalog doesn't even have very nice shirts in it now. And people said to me, are you going to wear a gown to the Golden Globes? And I said, absolutely not. I got a farmer's tan. I would look at, you know, where it's just, it would be absolutely hideous. And no, I'm going to just got to go to the Golden Globes and the Emmys. It's me. And I want to just let all the fashion snobs out there know that when I went to the Emmys, the shirt I had on my sister gave me, and it's an actual Ralph Lauren cowboy shirt.
The burden, it seems to me, is on the people now who want to defend the status quo, because the status quo is simply not working. I'm going to give you one example. There's not a single person in this audience would allow me to randomly assign their children to a Hartford public school. I want to repeat that, because I think this is important. There's not a single person in this audience would allow me to randomly assign their children to a Hartford public school. So the question I have for all of us is, whose children should go to schools that we would not allow our children to go to?
Dream, like lovers do, and it might come true. If I dream, it just might be the only time I'll be with you. When I dream of you.